Obviously, very, very disappointed with the game, way the game ended. Always a game that we expect to win. We're going to go back and we're going to find a million things we did well and a million things that we didn't do well. And that was the message to the team. It was kind of a tale of two games for us. First part, we were inconsistent offensively, didn't get enough stops defensively. We're kind of average on special teams. And then the end of the game where I was, very proud of our team's fight there at the end, and that's to get it back there to a tied game, have a great chance to win the football game. Says a lot about what we have in the locker room, says a lot about the culture that we have here at Oklahoma, and wasn't our best performance. We know that. We're going to own it. We don't back away from it. We're all a part of it, but we still found a way to give ourselves a chance to win it, and that's what we do. So we have been as good as anybody in the country over the last 3 years of responding to the very few losses that we've had. We've got a track record right there that you can put up against any team in the country. And that's absolutely what we expect to do again. It's going to take a lot of effort, going to take a lot of hard work. We've got to get better in a lot of areas. But we've got some fight in that room. We've got a bunch of guys that are incredibly disappointed right now, but they will be ready when we get back on the field here in a couple of weeks against TCU. So congratulations to Texas. They played a very good football game. Was one of the epic ones there. That's one that people will be talking about for years and years and years. And it was really a special atmosphere like it always is. I think the game lived up to the billing like it always does. So with that, we'll go questions.
James Hale, Sports Talk 1400, the ref. Lincoln, this was a tough day for your defense. You couldn't really get off the field. You have a chance at the end, and you can't get off the field. What happened to your defense today?
Yeah, we didn't tackle well. We missed too many big tackles in the open field. I didn't think we covered great. We had a few too many guys just getting beat in one-on-one situations. And then, the glaring deal was just the third and longs that we gave up. We gave up a third and 19. We gave up another third and extremely long where they carried the pile about 10 yards and gave up another couple there at the end. So we got to be better on third downs. We had a surge there at the end and played extremely well, more competitive, more like we expect to play there at the end. But obviously, we gave them too many, and that's something we all have got to do a better job with, coaches and players.
In the back.
Yeah, Lincoln, John Hoover, The Sporting News. Regarding the defense, did you like the plan going in? Did you guys have to make any tweaks defensively at halftime, changes? And I'm thinking especially on the goal line, there appeared to be several mismatches in numbers and blocking and personnel packages.
Of course I liked the plan. Thought we had a good plan, but in any game like this, there's going to have to be adjustments. There was adjustments on all three sides of the ball, I think. Texas offensively and defensively did some things we hadn't seen. We did some things that they hadn't seen. It was kind of a constant back and forth, but certainly we didn't get enough stops to win.
Garen Emig of the Tulsa World. Kenneth, both Kenneths, if you guys don't mind. I know you'll tip your cap to Ellinger. He played a very good game, obviously played a really good game for them. But just from your perspective, what did you guys do that made it difficult for you defensively today? What did you need to do more of defensively?
The obvious is we got to tackle better. I feel like we gave up way too many yards to the defense total. So, we gotta go in, we gotta go to work as far as practice and stuff like that, getting in the lab. Coaches put it in the game plan for us, and it's up to us to execute it. So us as players, we gotta go to work. We gotta go in there and, find what we need to do and get better. We didn't tackle well, which is the obvious, and obviously on third down, we weren't good. So, us as players, we take that personal, and we got to go get better at it.
Okay. Dean Blevins, News 9 Sports. Kyler, I wanted to ask you, this is your first loss at Oklahoma and combining high school. That's a whole bunch of wins. Just wonder what you're thinking and how big a factor those two turnovers were.
Yeah, obviously, not used to losing. Hurts, disappointed, but.
Thank you.
it's tough because, you know, I feel, if, you know, I turned the ball over and they didn't, and then I feel like that's just, you know, that's, you give them the advantage when you turn the ball over, and I feel like if I didn't turn the ball over, you know, we'd have a better shot at winning that game. Obviously, we didn't play as well as we wanted to offensively in the first half. The second half, I think we did a lot of good things, but we knew coming into this game it was going to be a four-quarter game, and we got to be better. We're better than that, and I know we're better than that, and it's just tough.
Yeah, Lincoln, Jason Kersey with The Athletic. You talk about missed tackles, poor coverage. Those feel like things that have kind of been recurring problems. What gives you confidence that you can still improve them this season?
People in that locker room. You know, the end of that football game, when a lot of times teams when you're down 21 in an atmosphere like this, you're incredibly disappointed. 99% of teams pack it up right there, and we didn't. And so we all got to own it. We all got to be better, and I have every confidence that every person in that room will do that.
Kirk.
Kirk Bowles from the Austin American. Lincoln, Texas really hadn't been nationally relevant since 2009. Do you have any fears that now that they're 5-1, that this kind of season and performance today could wake up that program?
I don't think one game or one thing ever does anything. I say it doesn't do anything, but I don't know. You know, that's their program. You know, that's not our program. You know, we've been nationally relevant for a long time. We plan on keeping it that way.
Brian.
Yeah, for Kenneth, Brian Davis, Austin American Statesman. You know, Ellinger has not run as much this year. He's trying to stay in the pocket. Were y'all surprised that he ran as much as he did and he had success?
No, not at all. I mean, we knew coming into the game that in critical situations, they wanted him, had a ball in his hand. So, I mean, for him to run the ball the way he did today, you know, that wasn't a surprise to me. I knew they were going to try to get the quarterback involved, being that he was, you know, pretty much their best rusher. So I pretty much knew that from the jump. In critical situations, they were going to, you know, try to get the ball in his hands.
Brennan Drum, OUInsider.com. For Lincoln or both Kenneths, looked to be a little bit of confusion in the first half, kind of with lining up. Was Texas doing some things that maybe y'all didn't see on film previously?
Oh, there's a few things here and there. I think it was just the flow of the game, a lot of check with knees from the sideline, and when that happens, you know, you're going to be moving your calls as well. So us getting lined up was not a factor, defensively.
Yeah, Barry Trammell with the Oklahoman. Both Kenneths, you guys didn't get a stop until that third quarter. What was the frustration level like as Texas kept getting the ball and kept scoring and you guys not getting a stop?
I mean, obviously, as a defense as a whole, you're real frustrated when you don't get a stop. But the thing that I was preaching to everybody on the sideline on defense is just keep fighting. You know, we came into this game, we got hit with adversity, we weren't able to get stops. But I'm proud of the way that we came together and we fought and we continued to fight throughout the game. So, I mean, obviously, not getting stops is frustrating. It's something that we got to go in and hone on. Something we got to take personal. We got to take that personal to go out there and get better. But, you know, I'm just proud of the way that we fought all the way through the game.
I agree with what he said. Like he said, of course it's frustrating on a defensive standpoint of them keep on converting, you know. We got to get off the field. But we kept fighting to the end. I'm proud of the way we fought, and we're going to come back stronger.
Cedric.
Oh, yeah, Cedric Golden, Austin American Statesman. Kyler, you and Sam put on a show today, and y'all had a little moment where you met at the end of the game near the end zone. What did you guys say to each other?
I have no comment on that.
Anyone else?
Hey, Tyler Palmetier, the Norman Transcript. Kyler, you mentioned the turnovers. Could you walk us through those and on the pass? Was it a ball that you feel like you shouldn't have thrown? Was it underthrown? And on the fumble, was it were you trying to keep the play alive when the ball came out?
First throw, kind of lost my footing, but you know, knowing the coverage and, you know, knowing the situation, shouldn't have tried to fit it in there. And then, you know, the second one hurts just because Coach Riley's, you know, he's preached to me all the time, you know, ball security in the pocket, and then it ended up in a big game. And I don't know how many times he's told me that. So that one definitely hurts.
Joe Masada, the Oklahoman. Lincoln, can you kind of walk through those last two offensive plays, especially that second to last? lining Austin up at quarterback and Kyler in the slot and just kind of what you all were trying to do there?
No.
Next.
Sean Gerard, Dave Campbell, Texas Football. Lincoln, from last year compared to this year, what have you seen differently from Ehlinger, both on film and what you saw today?
I thought he was pretty similar in both games. I thought he played well against us last year, ran the ball tough, made some nice throws last year. And I think he's, you know, continued that. He's certainly, you know, I think certainly fair to say that he's improving like you would expect he was. But I thought he, you know, did a good job last year in this game and did a good job again today.
Then we'll have one more.
Sean Isabella, CNHI. Lincoln, their wide receivers, obviously have some size. What was your plan going in? How do you think you executed defending their big wide receivers on the outside?
We weren't great there. You know, we did a decent job defending the vertical ball, you know, which we knew that was going to be a big part of their plan, especially with their size advantage, which they're going to have size advantage on. There's not a lot of 6'4 corners running around there. So, I mean, they're going to have a size advantage on most people. The thing I was most disappointed is we didn't defend the slants, the inside routes as good as we need to, and then we let them get loose and didn't get them on the ground a few times. So, didn't give them the big ones. But at the same time, some of the yards after the catch and the inside slant certainly hurt us.
Last question.
Yeah, Kyler, your future obviously is a little different with the baseball contract you have coming your way. Did you approach this game like this was your one shot at Texas?
I mean, obviously, going into this season, knowing that this could be possibly my last season, every game is, you know, a last shot at every team that I play against. So,
Coach, guys, thank you. Good luck the rest of the year.